हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू योर ऑफिस ऑटोमेशन लैब फॉर थर्ड सेम आईटी। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव कंप्लीटेड द वर्ड असाइनमेंट एंड इन दिस वीडियो क्लास आई विल स्टार्ट एमएस एक्सेल। एमएस एक्सेल इज ए स्प्रेडशीट सॉफ्टवेयर थ्रू व्हिच वी कैन एंटर द न्यूमेरिक डेटा, एनालाइज इट एंड कैन प्रिंट रिपोर्ट, कैन जनरेट चार्ट। सो Let's discuss about MS Excel. So, MS Excel is a spreadsheet program which is used to enter numeric data and analyze the numeric data. It is a spreadsheet software that consists of row and column. And Excel is a commonly used Microsoft Office application. It comes in the Office suite. Okay, and the extension of MS Excel is .xlsx. Okay, XLSX. And the extension of MS Word is .docx. The data in MS Excel is usually in a tabular form. Okay, so it is easy to analyze the numeric data in a tabular form. MS Excel is in a tabular format consisting of rows and column. Row means row runs horizontally and column runs vertically. Each row is identified with a row number, okay, from 1 to 3 onward, and the column is named as A, B, C, D. And in MS Excel 2010, the row is from 1 to 10,48,576. And column is from A to X, F, D. Means after Z, it again start with A, 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 B, A, C. Okay. So, it is 16,384 column. Means Excel is a spreadsheet software which consists with rows and column, and intersection of row and column is known as cell. So how can we open MS Excel? So click on start, then all program, or we can go to the search button and write MS Excel, or from all program we can click on MS Office or MS Excel. So, there are some most important component of Excel. So, let's discuss about it. First one is cell. A cell is the smallest but most powerful part of a spreadsheet. Actually, cell is the intersection of row and column. You can enter your data into a cell either by typing or by copy paste. Data can be of text type, number type or date type, and you can customize it by changing its size, font color, background color, border, etc. And every cell is identified with its address. Means every cell has its own unique address. Okay, through column number and row number. Means if a cell is at row number 1 and column B, then it will be denoted as B1. Okay. Like for example here, the cell address contains its column number and row number. If cell is 11th row and on AB column, then the address will be AB11. Okay. So, every cell has its own address. Then next is worksheet. A worksheet is made up of individual cell which can contain a value, a formula or text. It also has an invisible draw layer which hold chart, image and diagram. Means we can insert chart, we can insert image and diagram in every sheet of a workbook. Each worksheet in a workbook is accessible by clicking the tab at the bottom of the workbook. Means there are two concepts. First one is worksheet, and a bunch of worksheet can make a workbook. Okay. So in addition, a workbook can store chart sheet. A chart sheet displays single chart and is accessible by clicking a tab. Okay. Means a workbook can contain number of sheet and number of chart sheet. And workbook is a file. It is just like every other application have file. Workbook is a Excel file. Each workbook contain one or more worksheet, and you can also say that workbook is a collection of multiple worksheet. Okay, means multiple worksheet make workbook. You can add or delete worksheet, hide them within the workbook without deleting them, and change the order of worksheet within the workbook. So let's check what is workbook, what is worksheet, and what is cell in MS Excel. So to start MS Excel, just here type in search bar, you write MS Excel or click on Excel. Click on blank workbook, and the window is like MS Word window. First it is title bar. These are tab on the ribbon. This is the ribbon, and this one is quick access toolbar, and these are column named A, B, C, D. Okay, and these are rows number H 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is worksheet. Okay, we can insert worksheet by clicking the plus button. Okay, we can insert number of worksheet, and the number of worksheet will merge in the book 1. The default name is book 1. You can change the name by clicking on file and save as. Okay, and this is a cell, means intersection of row and column is a cell, and the cell address is here. This is the cell address, and this is formula bar. Okay, so this is the Excel window. This is about the Excel window. We can enter data, like we can generate series. You just write 1, then in second box, second cell write 2, select 2 consecutive cell, click on the fill handle. The small square is known as fill handle. Just select the fill handle and drag it. It will generate a list. Okay. We can generate like month name. It will generate the series automatically. So you can enter a number of numeric data, you can generate chart, you can generate what if analysis and analyze the data. Okay, we can generate report. So this is MS Excel, and after that we will look about some important function in MS Excel. Actually these are the Excel window component. This one is exactly like MS Word. The first is, this is ribbon, then these are the tab. Okay, as I have discussed, quick access toolbar, and this is formula bar. This is the new bar in MS Excel, and these are columns and these are rows, and we can enter worksheet by clicking the plus button. Okay, today I will discuss some common basic formula and functions, mainly the function used in MS Excel. Okay, we can write any formula in MS Excel by writing equal to symbol, then writing the formula. Like we can generate sum by using equal to, then the cell address A1 plus A2 plus A3, which find the sum of the range from A1 to A3. Okay, formula always start with equal to symbol. And functions are predefined formula in Excel. They eliminate the manual labor entry of formula while giving them human friendly name. Okay, means we have not write the formula, we only use the function predefined. There are many predefined function, and today I will discuss about some common function. So the first function is sum. The sum function is the first most known formula in Excel. It usually aggregate value from a selection of column or row from your selected range. Means it generate the sum of selected range. You can write equal to sum, then specify the number in a bracket. Okay, or you can specify the range B2 to G2 or A2 to A8. And then the next is average. The average function should remind you of simple average of data, such as the average number of shareholder in a given shareholding pool. Means it generates the average of some specific number just by adding it, like B2 to average B2 to B11. Means it will sum the number B2 to B11 and divide it by 10. Okay, this is the formula of average. Then count. Count function contains all cell in a given range that contain only numeric value. Means it count the number of cell in a series having numeric value. Okay, it only count the numeric value. And if, the next function is if. The if function is often used when you want to sort your data according to a given condition. The best part of if formula is that you can embed formula and function in it. Okay, means we can use and or not. And the if function syntax is, first write down equal to, then if, then the condition, then true value and false value. Okay, means if true, it store the true value. If this condition is false, then it will show the false value. Here is an example. If C2 is less than D3, then true, then false. If it is less than that, it will display true. Otherwise, it will display false. Then the max and minimum function. The max function will display the maximum number and minimum number in the range. Okay, means we can find the minimum and maximum from a range. Okay, so then the next function is round. The round function round a number to a specified number of digit. For example, if cell A1 contain 23.7825 and you want to round the value to 2 decimal, means up to 78, then it will display 23.78. By writing round A1, means A1 contain this value, A1 comma 2, means up to 2 decimal point, then it will display 23.78. Okay, so these are some example of round. Round 2.15 comma 1 means it will display 1 decimal value, and the number is 5, so it will be, result will be 2.2. okay, 1 will increases to 2 because the next number is 5. 5 greater than equal to 5 will increase the number to 1. Okay, next 2.149 comma 1 means again it will round up to 1 decimal number, but in this case it will be 2.1 because the next number is 4. Then minus 1 0.475, then comma 2 means it will round up to 2 digit. So 47 will, the next number is 5, then it will be minus 1.48. Okay. The next is 21.5 comma minus 1. Minus 1 means it will decreases the value from the decimal point left to the decimal point, means 21 will decreases to 20. Okay. So this is all about the function. So now let us do it in MS Excel. Let us check all these functions in MS Excel. First one is sum. So write equal to and sum, and then select the range, and it will display all the value in sum. So this is the value of sum, and we can also generate average. To generate average, just click on the cell, then equal to, then click the range. Sorry, first write down the average function name. Okay. Average, then in bracket, select the range. It will display the average. Okay. We can also find the maximum value and minimum value. So to find the maximum value, max, we can also write number here. I am writing here number 12, 45 and 89. And the max number is 89. So it will display 89. Okay. And to find minimum, then write down mean. And write the number 45, 7, 91, and it will display 7. This is max and mean. And we also round a decimal number, round, and write any decimal number and the number up to you want to round. So 2, then it will be 56.78, but the next number is 9, so 78 will be 79. Okay, means 56.79. Okay, so this is some common functions that are used in MS Excel. And in next class, I will discuss about the assignment that are given in your syllabus. So thank you.